Okay. I'm very happy to be here, and I will make a presentation which is a little bit more educational and a little bit mathematical, but I will skip mathematics, I promise. So in any action we have three parts. Or in any solutions we have three parts. First part is just explained by do it. It's a target. The second part, how to do it. And is it possible? It's the third part. And our mind, evolution of our mind started from the do it. And many years later, so it was stage of planning, and it can be expressed by the question how to do it. What is the procedures to do it? And the third stage, is it possible at all? Is it possible? And this third stage appeared not late, maybe a few decades ago. And in ancient Greece, philosophers and mathematicians spent their time posing problems and trying to solve them. And among these problems, there were such well-known problems, famous problems like squaring the circle or doubling the cube, and how to measure the diagonal of a square and size of this square. But measurement should be done in whole numbers because they didn't know other numbers. And for many years they tried to solve these problems. And they were successful in solving any other problem, but they could not solve these problems. And one day, one of Pythagoreans proved that the problem of measurement, a diagonal and sides of a square in whole numbers is impossible. It was a shock for Pythagoreans, because first time they met and solved the problem. Because they believed if you have a question and you have a well-defined question, then the problem, the answer for the decision is yes. But they obtained no. It was the first time. And this way, irrational numbers came from the shadow to the light. Another situation, in Middle Ages in Italy, mathematicians compete with each other trying to find a formula in radicals for polynomial equations. They were successful solving equations with equation of degree 1, 2, 3 and 4, but after 5 it was possible. But it was proved many years later by Haber and Galois. And so we steadily come to the notion of algorithm. First, it was stated in 1920 by him in the list of his known very important mathematical problems. And later, in 1936-37, exact notion of algorithm was formalized. And immediately, unsolved problems had appeared. Mathematicians proved that some problems, among them, holding problem for Turing machine, is unsolvable. The most interesting case and the most interesting topic started from 1976. Statement, transmit data through open channels without distributing secret keys. According to classical way of thinking, simple way of thinking, it's impossible. The answer should be no, but the answer is yes. It was discovered first by Diffie-Hellman, then RSA scheme appeared, and also I would like to say that it's very important was Vassar Mikhailis' scheme, which opened non-deterministic cryptography. And the main achievements of public key cryptography are digital signature and hash functions. And also using this mechanism, blockchain appeared and it is developing now and will be developed in future. So if we show this process in line and time, you can see main paradigms. Pythagoreans, and then we come to cryptocurrency. Algorithms, very famous names. It's notions of algorithms. It is very interesting that all different definitions of algorithms, they are equivalent. They can be expressed by each other. And we can see that these paradigms, they generate exponential growth. Now we have a very interesting time. We have blockchain, Internet of Things, cryptocurrency, atomic swap, and other problems which have a great impact on the development of information technologies. So it's very interesting that we can watch this diagram. And problem with proof of work. If you use proof of work, then we can solve some blockchain consensus problem. It's very important problem, a well-studied problem, and so we don't have very good solutions. In classic, in Bitcoin, we have hash aggregation, and we find miners must find such nonce in order to obtain solution of this aggregation. I do think that Satoshi Nakamoto and maybe some other people, creators of Bitcoin network, they believe that the process is sequential. But this process very easily parallelized. Therefore, it led to centralization of mining. We know that we have farms, pools, clouds, and a lot of computational power involved in mining. And the problem is how to equalize miners. Of course, now it's impossible in Bitcoin because the system is stable and solid, and it's difficult to change to the central mechanism of this system. But in general, how to equalize miners? So I think that we have requirements for proof of work. Computations could be done in parallel. They could not be done in parallel. This is very important because they should be strictly sequential. Of course, green computations are easy to verify, and some lucky chances to win should be present for a miner. And recent solution was proposed in the paper, which you can the address of the paper you can see here on this slide. But I'm not still sure that it cannot be parallelized. This problem is a parallel-based problem. Definition is simple, algorithm is difficult, but verifying is very, very easy. So decentralizing must have the following scheme. We must invent fully sequential integer generator, but it must be mathematically proved, not simply just give some generator, but it should be proved that it cannot be parallelized. And we have predicate integers from this generator come to predicate. Predicate is checked. If false, next integer comes into predicate, and if we have true, we have winner. The most interesting, most important part is that it will be sequential generator. We must expel parallelism. Do you know many really sequential procedures? I'm not sure that I can present many sequentials, fully sequential procedures. One of them is very well known puzzle, which is called Hanoi Tower. There is a tower in one road, there are three roads, and a tower of disks in one of these roads. And it's necessary to carry this tower to another road, but using some restriction. The bigger disk cannot lie on the smaller one. It's really interesting problem. For N disks, it's very easy to solve it mathematically. If we have N disks, so we can use it, we can use recursion, solve the problem too with N minus one disk, and then simply solve the problem for N disks. Very simple solution. If we imagine some creature that solves this Hanoi Tower, so its recursive behavior would be expressed this way. But the most interesting for me, and I would like to present it here, to use blockchain, better to say blockchain consensus problem, based on b-adic numbers. It's very interesting numbers, but really it's not integers, they're not, it's constructions which are called b-adic numbers. Invented in 1897 by Kurt Herzl. Periodic number is a sequence of integers, but it's infinite sequence of integers with very interesting properties. I will not give a mathematical lecture now. I will only stress that it's a very interesting object for study, and it's studied by mathematicians, and it's many, many good results are obtained here. And what is very interesting? It's very interesting. So we have so-called Hetzel's lemma, which states, if we have polynomial with integer coefficients, and we have a decision of this polynomial prime modulo p, prime p should be prime number, then there exists p-adic extension of x0, of x0. And the structure of this extension is presented here. And it's possible to calculate these coefficients x0, x1 from x0, x2 from x0, x1, and xn from all previous coefficients. It's very important that finding all these coefficients for x, x is a part of a periodic number, is strictly sequential process. You cannot parallelize it. And the computations how to compute these numbers is given very simple linear periodic equation. And procedure Hetzel gives us decisions. You can see very simple in the left corner it's iterative procedure, and in the right corner the same procedure is written in algorithmic form. And properties of these results are given, so they implies from they followed from periodic numbers. So we suggest Hetzel's mine. So first of all, procedure Hetzel it produces integers and predicate checks if they are true or false. And how to create such a equation for periodic numbers? We add names to blocks. Each block has a name. And a block which wants to be added, its name of this block should be calculated. And we have information, current information H sub E. We have previous block with a name n e minus 1, and we have to calculate. We have to solve equation in periodic numbers, and x m could be the name of the last block. that we have mining procedure, and proof of work is very simple, but not only predicate should be checked, but verifier should be persuaded that a miner uses Hensel's lemma. Not no other way to compute these coefficients. And it's easy. Using periodic number properties, it's easy, really easy. And this is the structure of verifier. It's interesting that it's possible using the Hensel's lemma, use not only the last block in the consideration, but also the previous block. So in order to change such a blockchain based on this structure, it's necessary to change not only the future, but the past, which is completely impossible, but the deep past. Conclusions. Algorithmic paradigms have been evolutionized and led to new paradigms in cryptography. So algorithm led to cryptography. It's interesting. Blockchain technology and related direction is a driving force for modern cryptography. And the future of blockchain demands finding new mathematical backgrounds. For sure, it's not only periodic numbers, but it's maybe some other numbers, some other construction can be used. And of course, this is not the end of the story. Future will come. Thank you for your attention.